Hi everyone. Well, today I want to share with you my recipe for making a baked pumpkin and pumpkin puree. Now, super easy, doesn't even require using the oven. If you've never had fresh pumpkin puree and have only had the canned, then you are in for a real treat. But before I show you how to do that, I just wanted to show you around my house a bit and show you how I'm decorating for fall. I spend so much time out in the garden that I don't have a lot of extra time to decorate. So what I did this year is I just bought some different pumpkins of various shapes, colors, and sizes, and just kind of set them around the house just to get the nice orange fall color going on. Now I've got an orange couch, so the mixing's a little bit easier because everything matches, which is a lot of fun. But here on my dining room, I already had this container with the plant in it. So all I did was just buy some gourds, white pumpkins. I had some butternut squash from the garden, and just to give things a little bit of color, a little festive look, and the kids and camera guy really enjoy it. But let's talk about pumpkin puree. Now, I absolutely love fresh pumpkin puree. It's really fun to make for pumpkin pies, pumpkin muffins, pumpkin breads. Of course, the fall is the prime time for that. Pumpkin smoothies are absolutely delicious. Now, let me show you the absolute easiest way in the world to bake a pumpkin. You can certainly bake it in the oven if you like to, but here's what I like to do. I like to use my crock pot and these small little sugar baby pumpkins. Now, these things are amazing for baked goods. They're nice and sweet. And the great thing about it is they're small. They fit right in my crock pot. Don't even have to cut them up. I can just bake them in here whole. So just pop one in. If you have a big crock pot, you might be able to fit a couple. I can just fit one in mine. So I have my crock pot on high. Just pop it in there. Gonna let it bake for about 3 to 4 hours, and we'll come back and check on it. Well, my pumpkin's been baking in my crock pot for about 4 hours, so let's check it and see if it's done yet. It's looking good. Ooh, look at all that steam. That's definitely a good sign. Now what I like to do is just give a little poke with the fork. Oh, that fork goes in really easily, so that means it's getting done. So let's pull it out and I'll show you how to make the pumpkin puree. Okay, I'm just gonna pull it out with a fork and a spoon here because it is super, super hot. Put it here on my cutting board. Now, typically I would let it cool off for a little bit so that I can handle it easily, but I do need to get this pumpkin puree made today. So what I'm gonna do is just hang on to it with a cloth, and I'll show you how easy this is to cut open. Once it's nice and soft in the crock pot, there's no like worried about cutting your fingers or anything like that. The knife just slides right through. Should probably cut the end off first here, the stem. Make it a whole lot easier. Look how easy that is. Oh, it's just steaming hot. Wow, that's absolutely beautiful. Look at all those seeds. It looks absolutely gorgeous. I'm gonna scoop those seeds out because who knows, I might wanna save them and bake them or roast them later. I'm actually gonna use my ice cream scoop here like I did with the butternut squash. So I'll just scoop these out. It is hot, so you wanna be careful. There's a lot of seeds in here. This would be great for roast pumpkin seeds. I actually do have a video on how to roast pumpkin seeds and flavor it with, I think it's like some dark chocolate and some other spices and seasonings. That's super easy to do. Wow, this is gonna be so nice in my pumpkin kombucha. Wow, there's a ton of pumpkin seeds in here. So this flush scoops out so easily. The ice cream scoop, I really like using an ice cream scoop. Well, I absolutely love how quick this is. It makes such quick work at a pumpkin puree. It's nice and soft already. Now at this point, if you want to, you can put it in the blender to make it really smooth, but I'm just gonna mash it up with a fork. And then what I like to do is just freeze it in ice cube trays. And you freeze it in the trays, then you pop them out, put them in a plastic freezer bag, And then you can just pull out, if you need a small amount for a smoothie or for my pumpkin kombucha, just pull out a couple of cubes and use it for whatever you need it for. Makes it super handy. Well, I ended up getting about an ice cube tray and a half here of my pumpkin puree. It's gonna really freeze up nicely into little cubes. I cannot wait to flavor my kombucha because the homemade is so much better than the canned store-bought. Well, there you have it. It's so easy to make your own pumpkin puree. So much tastier than what you buy from the store and eat in a can. Hope you enjoyed spending time with me here today in my kitchen. I know I enjoyed spending time with you. Please comment below. Let me know what videos you'd like to see here on my channel this winter. I can't wait to hear your feedback. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye. That a quick rinse. And then we're going to pour all these seeds in a pot of boiling salted water. And what that's gonna do is just make all the extra